In 2005, Amy Pickering left the confines of her cubicle at the APA and went to Sri Lanka. The area had recently been destroyed by a giant tsunami. She began installing water purification devices so that residents had clean water to drink. She soon realized that she had a knack for this line of work. A Fulbright scholarship and a PhD later, Amy is now a scientist doing what she loves. This is her story. An environmental engineer by training, Amy is officially a research associate at Stanford University.
I work on designing and evaluating interventions or technologies to improve access to safe water in low-income countries.
A sampling of her projects include a device that cleans water in the slums of Bangladesh and a hand-washing station for use in Kenya.
I probably spend about 20% of my time in the field in Kenya or Bangladesh or whatever country I'm working in.
Over the years, Amy has perfected the art of packing. She also enjoys the simple pleasures of traveling.
I love jet lag. I love being awake in the middle of the night when no one else is awake.
On her journeys, she brings a tiny Buddha with her, upon which her husband writes her notes. In the field, Amy runs research studies and collects data to see how effective different devices are at cleaning water and preventing the spread of diseases. She also collects toy animals and coins. But Amy didn't completely escape office life when she left the EPA. When she's not traveling, she lives in San Francisco and routinely drives for 50 minutes in her red Prius to her office at Stanford.
I like to do activities in the morning that require a lot of brain power. I'll write up my research for scientific publications. I'll do data analysis.
In the afternoons, she often advises graduate students or tests new devices in the lab. Amy doesn't seem to mind this type of office work.
I do research, and one of the best things about research is that you're building this knowledge base that can then be used to design and implement programs that are going to improve quality of life. And so that's what I think really motivates me.
For students interested in science, Amy has some advice.
So I would say don't be intimidated. Success is a combination of hard work and determination, not necessarily talent or innate ability. People that are successful just work really hard, so you can do it.
And that is Amy's story.